Hello dear learners, today I welcome you all for the discussion on MCQs from pharmaceutical chemistry from the chapter enthalmintic drugs. Before going to the MCQs on enthalmintic drugs, I will request you all to please go through the videos the link of which I have shared it in the description box. The first question from the MCQs is, helminthiasis is also known as, whether it is known as helminth infection, whether it is known as worm infection, whether it is known as macroparasitic infection, or all of them. The correct answer is, it is all of them, because according to the definition of helminthiasis, it is also known as helminth infection or worm infection, which is a process wherein macroparasites infect or invade humans and other animals. So, helminth infection is also correct, worm infection is also correct, and they are macroparasites. So, all of them. Next question is, enthalmintics dash, whether they expel or kill the parasitic worm, whether it is a worm infection, macroparasitic infection, or all of them. The correct answer is, enthalmintics expel or kill the parasitic worm by various mechanisms such as paralyzing them, etc. Next question is, symptoms of helminthiasis is symptom, abdominal pain, diarrhea, eosinophilia, abdominal pain. Yes, it is a symptom of helminthiasis. Diarrhea is also one of the symptoms of helminthiasis. And eosinophilia, that is increase in WBC, is also one of the symptoms of helminthiasis. Other symptoms are GI inflammation, dehydration, fever, fatigue, anorexia, etc. So, the correct answer is, it is all of them. Nematodes are dash, whether they are roundworms, flatworms, tapeworms. That means nematode is a phylum, and nematode phylum includes what? Whether roundworm, flatworm, tapeworm, or none of them. The correct answer is, it is roundworm. Next question is, tapeworm belonging to phylum dash. Tapeworm comes into which phylum, whether it is a nematode, cestode, or trematode. Now, nematode, cestode, trematode is the phylum, they are the phylum's name, and worms belongs to these respective phylums. Nematode contains whipworm, roundworm, pinworm, etc. Cestode, specifically tapeworm, trematode, flukes. So, the correct answer is, it is cestode. Tapeworm belongs to cestode. Next question is, roundworm infection is dash, whether it is called as amoebiasis, whether it is called as ascariasis, whether it is called as endocarditis, or whether it is called as dermatitis. The correct answer is, it is ascariasis. Roundworm infection is also called as ascariasis. Next question is, flukes belong to phylum dash. Now, whether it is a nematode phylum, cestode phylum, trematode phylum, or ascarids, the correct answer is, it is trematode. Trematode phylum includes flukes. Next question is, whipworm belongs to phylum dash, whether it is nematode, cestode, trematode, or ascarids, the correct answer is, it is nematode. Nematode includes whipworm, roundworm, pinworm, etc. Next question is, nematode includes, now just now we discussed, nematode includes what all worms? First roundworm, yes, it is there. Whipworm, it is also there. Pinworm, yes. So, the correct answer is, it is all of them. Nematodes includes roundworm, whipworm, pinworms, etc. Next question is, piperazine citrate acts by dash, whether they selectively block the neuromuscular agent, whether they bind to GABA receptor, whether they paralyze the worm, or all of them? The correct answer is it is all of them. So according to the mechanism of action is they cause the hyperpolarization along the nerve endings. They are a selective neuromuscular blocking agent in the parasite, and since the neuromuscular blocking agent, since they will loosen the muscle movements, or they will specifically stop the muscle movements, so they will paralyze the worms, and once the worms are paralyzed, they are expelled into the stool through the intestinal peristalsis, and this piperazine citrate will bind to the GABA receptor, which is inhibitory in nature, so which is responsible for causing the hyperpolarization. Next question is, DASH is a benzimidazole derivative. Whether it's a mebendazole, whether it is piperazine citrate, whether it is DEC or pyrantel palmoate, the correct answer is it is mebendazole. Other examples from the benzimidazole derivatives are include mebendazole, then albendazole is also one of the benzimidazole derivative, that means they contains benzimidazole in it, imidazole heterocycle which is attached with the benzene. Next question is, DASH is a piperazine derivative. Now mebendazole we have seen, it is benzimidazole derivative. Piperazine citrate is piperazine itself with the citrate as a salt. Then DEC, that is diethyl carbamazine citrate. So DEC contains piperazine nucleus and pyrantel palmoate. The correct answer is it is DEC. Next question is, drugs used for nematodes are whether mebendazole, DEC, pyrantel palmoate or all of them. So according to the classification of enthalmintic drugs, according to the phylum they are classified. That is enthalmintics which are acting on the phylum nematode, enthalmintics which are acting on the cestode, and drugs which are used for trematodes. So according to the classification, nematode drugs used for nematode treatments are mebendazole, DEC, pyrantel palmoate, all of them. So the correct answer is it is all of them. Next question is, mebendazole is active against, whether it is active against threadworm, roundworm, hookworm or all of them. The correct answer is it is all of them. I will request here again for the uses, just go through the video on the uses. Pyrantel palmoate is used in DASH, whether it is in threadworm, roundworm, hookworm or all of them. The pyrantel palmoate, it is used in all of them. Treatment of threadworm infection, roundworm infection as well as hookworm infection. Next question is, DASH is used in filariasis. Now filariasis treatment, if you will see the uses, then filariasis in trick we have called it as fila shoes, which we generally wear it in the December. So DEC is the major which is used in treatment of filariasis, and the other drugs are albendazole is also there, pyrantel palmoate is also there, then mebendazole is also there. So the correct answer is it is all of them. Next question is, tapeworm infection affecting liver, lungs and brain is, whether it's a filariasis, whether it is ascariasis, whether it is hydatid disease or none of them. So as we have seen, ascariasis is nothing but small intestine infection, filariasis is a roundworm infection, ascariasis is also a roundworm infection, but it is confined to small intestine. Then hydatid disease is a tapeworm infection. So hydatid disease is a tapeworm infection which affects liver, lungs, brains, etc. So the correct answer is it is hydatid disease. Next question is, mebendazole is used in, whether it is used in ascariasis, yes, because it's a roundworm infection. Filariasis, again it's a roundworm infection. Hydatid disease, yes, it is also effective in hydatid disease, and all of them. So the correct answer is it is all of them. Along with these, mebendazole is also used in topical or pulmonary eosinophilia, that is increase in WBC treatment. Next question is, brand names of mebendazole are, whether it is Mebex, Vermin, Dicarmetrazone, Unimax, Ceptran, or none of them. The correct answer is it is Mebex and Vermin. And other brands of mebendazole are Mebazole, Mendazole, Ebane, etc. Next question is, IUPAC of DEC is, now this is the structure. This structure is combined with the citrate salt. Now, if you will look into the correct answer, it is NN1-diethyl. Now, if you will see, this is a piperazine ring. This is methyl. This is carboxamide. And this is diethyl. And this is amine. So, this NN1-diethyl. So, this is N CH2CH3, CH2CH3. So, it is diethyl. At fourth position, there is methyl. This is the piperazine ring. Piperazine ring's first position contains carboxamide and plus dot citrate salt. The correct answer is first option. Next question, DEC is used in filariasis. Yes, it is used in filariasis, eosinophilia. It is also used in treatment of prophylaxis and treatment of filariasis and eosinophilia. Then third is W. Bancrofti infection. That means it is also active against W. Bancrofti and all of them. The correct answer is it is all of them. DEC is used in filariasis, eosinophilia, prophylactic as well as treatment. Then it is also active against W. Bancrofti. So the correct answer is it is all of them. Next question is, which of these is not an enthalmintic? Whether it's a mebendazole, DEC, piperazine citrate or pyrazinamide, the correct answer is it is pyrazinamide, which is not an enthalmintic drug. Pyrazinamide is an antitubercular drug. Next question. With this, we finish with the few of the MCQs which are possible on enthalmintic drugs. Thank you.